Hi, everybody. My name's Tim. I have a 2016 Harley Rogue King. I'm sure you're tuning in because of it. Thank you for watching my video first. And this is my second Harley. My first would be this little guy, the 883 2002 Sportster. And I figured I'd upgrade to this guy. Really enjoy the bike, very comfortable. I've added some features to it, and most notably the sound system, which is going to be what I'm talking about in this video. First, I'm going to talk about the setup. First, I started off with two Rockford Fosgate 6.5-inch wakeboard speakers and had to order the bracket separately. Next, I went with replacing the lids with cutout lids. You can order those online. These are about $250, somewhere in there. I put five-way 6x9s in there. Cut the lid open. These are 600 watt max power, 100 watt speakers, RMS. What I did is I put a quick release on here. So all I have to do is pop that off, the bag pops off, and I can get to the wheel assembly if I need to. On the other side is where I hold the amplifier. This is a NVX mini amplifier, a little bigger than a deck of cards, and believe it or not, this thing is unbelievably good. 100 watts per channel, and I believe the amp runs about $150 to $200, depending on where you get it. For the audio system, most people do a Bluetooth or they'll do a wire with a plug into the headphone jack. They'll mount it right here in the gas tank. I'm not a fan of doing that. Harley sells a nice cell phone holder. They're kind of pricey. You go to Harley, you're going to spend a little bit of money, but it works well for me. It'll hold any size phone, completely adjustable for any size. Pops right in there. But on the back side, I went to Wet Sounds. They make a lot of boat audio equipment. And this little device here actually is the Bluetooth device. So Bluetooth from my phone to there. So when I'm cruising down the road, I can reach over, hold the volume open, and it'll turn the volume up, turn the volume down. If I push the button, it pauses the song. Push it again, it unpauses it, and if you click it real quick, it'll pop to the next song. All this without messing with my phone while I'm riding down the road. If you have a cell phone on your bike and you find yourself touching the volume control, or if you're wearing gloves, it's a pain in the butt to start touching the screen and trying to flip to a next song, especially if it's one you're not in the mood of hearing. You might be wondering what this wire is sticking out. I am engaged, so my fiance loves to ride with me. I ran a power cord for her cell phone. And this just came in the mail today. This little guy here kind of wraps around, but if I pull it out here, it'll hold her cell phone for her and kind of holds over her lap so she doesn't fumble with the phone while we're cruising down the road. And last but not least, one more accessory that I put on here. And a lot of people haven't heard of it. This little switch here. Flip this on. And if you push the button, you'll see center of the seat has a vibrator in it. It attaches to the RPM wire and it makes the passenger ride a lot more enjoyable. Thought maybe I would show you how it sounds. This is on a recording, so I apologize on camera. So I flip this in. This is the power cord to my phone. Get into the phone. Flip the bike on. Wait for the Bluetooth to connect. And get a song going. Usually it takes a second to connect on the Bluetooth.
Are you excited?
pause.